Weakened by the One Ring's power, at last Frodo claims it for himself, and the very foundations of Middle-earth are shaken. The Dark Lord desperately hopes for his very body to be restored to him. But to stride forth upon Middle-earth once more, Sauron requires Frodo's ring, and for this he will gladly pay any price. At the Dark Lord's command, his Nazgûl now hasten to Mount Doom, all other thoughts banished from their minds. They obey but a single deadly aim, to slay Frodo and gain the ring, now that it lies within Sauron's grasp. Many orc garrisons boldly dare to covet the ring for themselves, rising up in riot and civil war, and marching upon Mount Doom. But the onrushing Nazgûl shall tolerate no delay, and will slay any dark servant who dares block their path.
Betrayers hold the Witch King's mask within their prison. Seize it, fools! Slay any who stand in your way. There are no allies upon this road.
Magic.
fools, the Witch King fights once more! The world of men is over. Two captains command these traitors. They shall be the object of your wrath.
Caring not at all the cost, the Dark Lord's servants have regained for him the One Ring. Sensing that the tide has turned, the free people of Middle-earth must now retreat and prepare to defend their realms. The power of Sauron is restored, and few who still survive this war dare hope to oppose it. But the Dark Lord's pride remains stung by Gondor's recent victories, and he intends to extract full retribution. With new and vast powers, Sauron now resurrects his fallen chattel. He calls again to life many of his darkest heroes and champions, to slay once more in his name. Crossing the River Anduin under a blanket of darkness, an orc scouting force begins Sauron's renewed assault upon our world. The orc onslaught will be launched at midnight, striking like a dagger at the heart of Osgiliath. The most deadly blow shall be struck by an elite horde lying in wait upon the far shore. Their siege machines are poised to rain fire down upon the hated rangers. The orcs await signals from hidden scouts to identify their targets. For those dark hearts wish greatly to see Osgiliath burn.
Keep scouting, you maggots! Clear him out and light the signal flare! They might! Osgiliath burns! Lead it to the north end of the ruins with that flare! Get moving! The mouth of Sauron and our captains await the signal! Get a flare to our rallying point! Move it, dogs! Get it moving! We need a flare set in the North Ruins now! See a flare burning up in the north! We've got you, boys! Let's lick our wounds! Here comes Basilica Trouble! Defend this place until our captains get here! Nazgûl! Keep out of its way! They're coming out of that basilica! Keep them out of this place! Our boars have got to rally here! Away! Our captains are arriving! They got attackers coming from that basilica! Keep them away from our rallying place! and Rambor's. So let's go storm the stronghold with it. Keep going! We gotta get over to that place! The gate's right ahead! Prince of Gondor, quite fit for a stewpot. Stick him, or I can feast on royalty tonight.
Men of the West, your stand!
The Dark Lord must be pleased, for a ruined city has once more been ground beneath the boot of the Orc. Faramir and all of his men are shown no mercy, nor did they expect to receive it. And for Sauron's hordes, the road is again laid open into the heartland of Gondor. Now, within the camps of Mordor, the Dark Lord calls forth fresh legions. For this time, he shall utterly crush those who dare stand against him. Minas Tirith is breached. The gates are shattered and the lower walls of the city are overrun. The men of Gondor attempt a valiant defense, but Sauron's hordes have taken full measure of this frail city, and they will not be denied. The guards of the citadel shall defend their city to the last man, and it may soon come to that. They all fear the end draws near, for the darkness is nearly complete.
Listen, you maggots! We want to burn this place before night falls, to get to the next level! There's a yard there to be captured! Gondor is here! Take it to our Nazgûl master! We've got us the crown, boys! Crown! is on the north side of the city. Take the crown to him there. To the stairs where we came up. One last gate between us and that top, boys. They got the path to the gate blocked. Get there and clear away for our ram, maggot. To the top. This city's got a sick white tree up here. The boss wants it burned. Get a bonfire going with that filthy white tree! Burn that ugly white tree! Burn everything! Some of these weaklings. To the throne room! Master Sauron wants that throne, so go kill them guards in there!
Upon every level, Minas Tirith is burning. The gates lie shattered and the lower circles of the city are overrun. From the hallows where dead kings of Gondor watch in horror, to the white tree that burns, all is now in ruin. Orcs now hold banquet in the White Tower of Ecthelion and desecrate both king and commoner alike. Thus passes Minas Tirith, the White City, and with it the best hope for the world of men. The war must go on, but we have been grievously harmed. Upon their relentless march, the armies of Mordor must now pass through the mines of Moria. It is here that Gimli has chosen to make his final stand, but he and the other survivors have had no time to prepare their defenses. And Moria yet remains a dark and dangerous realm for all who dare enter its gates. It is feared that Sauron holds knowledge of Moria's darkest secrets and has charged his force with a terrible ritual. For the sake of the dwarf and his followers, we must hope the Dark Lord's power cannot yet call into this world a Balrog of Morgoth.
We got that Balrog altar built, and to bring that dead thing back, we need some magic stones. So into the mines with you. Let's go dig anything nasty out of the mines. We need us a place to rest up. Just lazy. Go grab those mines! Now! Ah! near that first chamber. We need to find magic stones. That weakling captain has a shiny stone. Asta wants to bring the demon thing back. So go kill him! You afraid of a tin captain and his shiny stone? Go get him! Get the first one. Nice work. He's bleeding like a stuck pig. Get the stone before it ain't shiny. Master says we need to kill some men to power the shiny stone before it goes to the altar. Get to it, new dogs. Prove it, you maggots. Start killing them weaklings. Stone to the altar! Keep finding stones! Master needs more to bring the fire demon back! Listen, maggots! Behind that door is some old dwarf's tomb. Let's pay our respects. Open that old tomb! Licking on that tomb. Ah! keeping him alive! Take it away! Need to get their power. Kill more men. Kill the filthy swine. Power for the stone! He's thirsty! Keep up the pace, maggots! More for the magic stone, you scum! To the altar. Once it's placed, we can call the Balrog back to life. Get away, you fools! A Balrog is coming back to life. So that dwarf thinks he owns the place. Let's bury him in it, boys.
Tomb.
The flame of Udun has been unleashed again upon the world of Middle-earth, and like his kin, the dwarf Gimli and all who dared follow him into the darkness have been slain by this creature. Moria now remains forever a place of evil that none dare enter. And now his Nazgûl venture forth once more to search out the Dark Lord's final victims. The armies of the West have been forced to make their final stand upon the ruins of Weathertop. Here, in ages past, the Witch King led his great host in terrible victory. And here, the northern armies of men were crushed. The Tower of Amon Sul reduced to ruin. Now the broken stones of this place shall bear witness to a last desperate struggle. For there can no longer be any retreat from the onrushing forces of darkness.
The age of men ends tonight! Aragorn must be slain! Come on, boys! Let's get started! Destroy the Gondorian emplacements! remember that, destroying their positions! So get to it! You maggots! Do you want how scum this close to us?
My realm. You are required to die.
Take out those captains of theirs now! Those cats! those nasty captains and teach them a lesson!
Aragorn, descendant of Isildur and king of all the free peoples, was at last vanquished. Our last and greatest hope for victory was in the end thrown down by the same barbaric creatures who killed his father years before. Now the ranks of the Dark Lord swell as a rising tide of malice and hatred, and all shall be overwhelmed by that great black wave. Rivendell has become an island, storms raging upon all sides. The last elves of Middle-earth have gathered with me here to make our final stand. Should the elves of Rivendell fail to halt Sauron's onrushing tide, little will remain to resist the smothering darkness. We must sacrifice our immortality here, in service of all that yet survives in Middle-earth.
Group, quick! Grab that area inside the gate!
Ah!
is ours! Listen up! Cross that river and grab the far side! Move it, boys! We got him mad!
Ah!
it! What are you getting tired, you maggots? Let's destroy some elf history! His cowardly face. Slay him!
Avenge our kin!
To the gate. Master wants it now. You've got his ring. Lord Sauron won't like that. Elrond dropped his ring of power. Get it and take it to the gate.
Bust up to the river house.
take their little river house and see where they hide. The river house is now the Orc house. Good work, boys. Now let's finish the job. Find that elf. Kill Legolas dead. Kill the Elf King. Put an end to all these elves.
My people could not defeat the Orc horde. Only a handful survived to carry on the fight. I was one of those unfortunate few. Only the kindest and most pure of Middle-earth's inhabitants still remain. And now the shadow of the Dark Lord prepares to fall upon them as well. At last the Dark Lord's iron fist encircles the innocence of the Shire. There will be no escape for the hobbits from the war that now enters their quiet borders. The last free men might attempt to aid them, but all must face an overwhelming enemy. Warg riders and great war beasts mass for the attack, and none left alive can withstand their power. Perhaps at last the Dark Lord himself shall come forth to gloat in his triumph. Perhaps then, with Gandalf, we might sell our own lives most dearly. In desperation, Treebeard leads the final march of the Ents. With their aid, and with many halfling archers, perhaps the Shire can resist for a brief while.
Those runts think they're safe in their little hobbit homes! Burn up those little grass houses!
coming! survive!
History is no more for this happy race. Their hobbit holes are now tombs, their party trees kindling, and those who survive are now enslaved by the Dark Lord Sauron. Treebeard was in the end no match for the fury of the orcs. He now serves as a bonfire into which halfling bodies are thrown. Even the great wizard Gandalf could not stand before the Dark Lord. He has fallen and cannot be restored. His purpose here has ended. Those who did not fight in this war shall now become the final victims. Their homes shall be burnt, and the future of their children shall be sacrificed upon Sauron's cruel altar. Death and ruin are all that shall remain, for the Dark Lord's cruelty will know no limits, and in the end all shall be destroyed. For now the darkness has covered all living things. And it has claimed us all.